Hello, this is the first episode of my little series with anecdotes and little stories about some experiences I made in the occult scene and while doing some magical workings and all that stuff. This is, as the first episode, also a little introduction to the whole series. In some of these videos, I will kind of divide the video into two parts, which means first I tell a story, and with some aspects of this story I will be, well, not exaggerating, but I will tell these stories first from a perspective that is kind of the same perspective that you would tell a fairy tale from. I will make these stories sound fantastic, more fantastic than they were, and in the second part of the video I will give my interpretations, my explanations of what happened and why it appeared like this and like that. So I will give an analysis of the story, which is which will be kind of like an excuse for the exaggeration and the special perspective from which I told the story that the video is about. Now, well, I think that was it for the introduction. Let's get on with the show. This first story happened to me many years ago, when I was still living in Bonn. There was a bookstore that was founded by the aforementioned Frater U.D., Ralf Tegtmeier. I do not really know why U.D. left Bonn. He moved back close to Bonn some years later, but in the meantime he lived in Belgium, and I really don't know. But quite possibly the reasons why he left weren't so good. In a part of that bookstore, an esoteric bookstore, in a part of that bookstore there was a section for magical books, like Crowley, Agrippa Fanaticime, Gregor Egregorius. I think he's not that well known in the English-speaking parts of the world, or outside of the German-speaking little part of the world. And different other magicians. You could find the Abramelin in that section of the bookstore. And that bookstore was that section of the bookstore was kind of guarded by something that UD forgot or left in that store. It's his replica of the Stale of Revealing. I could take it from the wall now, but I don't want to. And that bookstore closed in 2002. Short time after the euro was introduced as daily currency. And while it was closing, all the books were given away for very little, for a very little price. And I went there and I thought, well, now they might sell this Stale of Revealing replica they have hanging there. Because, well, the guys in that bookstore, after some time, knew me, because I was a quite frequent customer. And one of the people working there told me that this deal was not for sale. And people really came there and offered large amounts of money, I think 600 or 700 D-mark. And it was not for sale. So while the bookstore was closing, while everything was sold, I went there and I have to confess I thought about stealing the thing for a short time, but I don't like to do bullshit like that. So I stood in front of that thingy, and I really asked Hermes for help. Kind of like an invocation or evocation, some kind of cation. And after that occasion, sorry, I had to try it. After that, I went to the owner of that store and asked her if the TELE was for sale. And she said, "Well, of course, we all always sold that." And I knew she was lying. I already explained to you why. But that doesn't matter. If you want to buy something, you expect the person that sells you the stuff to lie a little bit. Well, that's... you know, the word merchant comes from Mercury somewhere, somehow. And Mercury is the trickster. He's good with words and twisting words. And she looked at the thingy and said, "Well, yeah, we sold them. Let's say I'll sell you this one for 80. And as I just said, Mercury is good with words, and I just invoked him. She didn't. It was short after the euro was introduced, and exchange rate was 2 D-mark for 1 euro, so I said, 80 D-mark, great, that's 40 euros. I'll go to the bank and get you the money." I kind of fast-talked her into selling me the thing for half the price she originally intended. Thank you, Mercury. But, well, I only tell you this story because I told it in the German version, and in the German version I originally didn't intend to tell that story. I wanted to tell you another story. About 2 years before that story, so 12 years ago, when I came into that bookstore, the guy behind the desk asked me if I was willing to get in contact with someone who came into that store and asked about someone who could explain something about magic to him. And I said, "Well, sure, why not?" And the guy gave me the number of that other dude. Let's call the dude Delaney. And if you know why I picked the name Delaney, you know why I call myself a Marxist. So I called Delaney, and we got together. He came over to me, and I was dumb and naive and intended to give him an overview of the different traditions, magical traditions. So I sat there and said, "Well, this is the Golden Dawn system, and that's Rosicrucian system, and that's the Thelemite system, that's Chaos Magic, that's Fraternity Saturni, that's that, and that's this, and this is alchemy, and heaven, and what have you." Well, I was stupid enough to be honest with him, so I included a little blue book that doesn't really deserve to be called book, because it's just a collection of pieces of paper with a little that are bound together by a little piece of plastic, and damn cheap, and it cost me about 25 euros, well, 50 D-marks. It's the book Ice Magic by Frater UD. Again, that asshole. And that system of ice magic, it appears to be interesting, it appears to be something worth spending some time with. From my perspective, it isn't, because what he did was he took a system a magical system based on the Kabbalah, and threw away 8 of the 10 Sephiroth. So you're left with 2 fields out of 10. And he is speculating on the people buying into that shit to be stupid enough to ignore the rest, to be ignorant enough not to look over the edge, not to look what else is there. Well, as I said, I was stupid enough to include that book in my little presentation to Delaney, and he asked me about that book. I said, well, that's Frater UD. I told him the story that I told you in my in-between video, and somehow that made him curious. Instead of telling him what kind of character that idiot Frater UD is. And after some months we met again, and he told me that he was visiting some of these seminars about ice magic that Frater UD gives for a lot of money. And in late 2001 we met for the last time. He again told me about the seminaries and the wonders he's seen there. And well, he appeared very close, on the edge to a psychosis or neurosis. I'm not a psychologist, so I can't really analyze that or give you the correct word, but he didn't appear like he used to appear to me. And what he told me, he told me that he has the feeling that people feel repulsed by him, but in the seminaries he pays so much money for. At that time it was 200 D-marks. As far as I know, the price has gone up, but I don't know if those seminaries are still given. In those seminaries, he was told that this reaction was to be expected, and that shows that the system works. Yeah, my ass. The demonstrations Frater UD gave in these seminaries are some tricks that, as far as I know, he stole from some martial artist who's doing a pretty good job. I really enjoyed taking a look at his webpage and the stuff he writes about. And in some forums where people talked about ice magic, they said the same thing. Well, no wonder, because that's where I got this information from. That Frater UD only stole this stuff, or copied it in a very bad manner, from that martial artist. And he knows two or three tricks from that martial artist that can be explained in a wonderful way by scientific things, like how the nervous system works and stuff like that. Sometimes some psychological tricks. But the big fraud about this ice magic system is Frater UD claims that his system doesn't need any preparations, and doesn't need a symbol system or any concepts and stuff like that. But he describes a concept, and he says that the way to prepare yourself for using that system is to pay him money to learn and learn his strange stuff. I could go into details, because I ripped that system in some forum, and it's a fraud. It's a big fraud. Why does he have categories like bad translation of the German term would be guiding your speech and guiding your body. that's basics in all kinds of real magical system, but it's in his system it's misplaced, because he says there are no categories needed in this system. Well, you are lucky, because he also says that this system can only work in German, and so you, as an English-speaking person, will be spared from being tempted to waste money on that bullshit. But this whole scam that UD uses, playing with the ignorance of people and luring them into giving him money, can be found in countless other people, fields, and in occultism and magic and in esoterics. And there is another aspect about this story why I wanted to tell it to you. In one of our first meetings, Delaney told me that he wanted to learn magic because he wanted to learn nothing big, just something like you could see in the first part of The Lord of the Rings, where Gandalf blows out some smoke and the smoke forms a beautiful ship that flies around. Well, you might remember that one video I made where I said there's fantasy magic, there's stage magic, and there's historic magic. And Delaney wanted to learn fantasy magic, but it's fantasy magic. It's fantasy, it's not real. Real magic is more like, well, another term for it is psychonautics. Getting to know yourself by introspection, by looking at aspects of your psyche that are hard to see. That's why meditation and stuff like that is important, which is a form of guiding the body. Introspection and all that stuff. And being honest to yourself when it comes to that. Not being misled by some promises of something, be it some stuff that's people disguise as something religious, something, some promises of holiness or whatever. And there's so much stuff that people fall for, and it, old tricks. It's, well, you know, when someone can guide you in a certain direction by hanging a carrot in front of your face, that means you're an ass. And unfortunately, especially when it comes to learning magic, many people provide those that trick them with that carrot. They come to them and say, hey, here's my carrot, please let it dangle in front of my eyes. You don't do yourself a favor while doing that. And now I'm getting into some kind of tantrum and some kind of pseudo-moralistic rant, and I don't want to do that. That's why I end the video, and I wish you all the joy in the world. Enjoy your time, enjoy your day, enjoy your life, enjoy yourself, enjoy everything, and have a good time. See ya.